Hello people and welcome! Let's see how to add effects and transitions with Premiere Pro CC. Leave comments to correct mistakes in our English. Let's see the effects. You have two main kinds of effects, video effects and audio effects, depending on the kind of your clip. Audio effects affect just sound or speech, while video effects interest images, videos and text. If you zoom in enough, you will notice an FX icon symbol after or before the clip name description. If you click on it, you will have a list of standard effects that are present in any clip by default and can't be deleted. As video effects, you have motion, used to rule how the clip has to move in the preview, opacity, to make it transparent, and time remapping, used to change the playing speed. A blue point indicates you which kind of effect you have selected at the moment. You can select just one effect per time in this way. If the thread that contains the interesting clip is large enough, you will notice a line on the clip. This is called envelope line and indicates the value of the selected effect time by time. For example, if you have selected the opacity effect with the FX icon, click and drag on the line to change it. A small white box will tell you the exact value. If you want to be more precise, simply pull the line while holding Hold down. Release the line to see how your clip looks like in the preview. Time remapping is a little different. The percentage appearing means how much faster you are playing the clip. Above 100% is faster. Below is lower. The different playing speed modifies the total length of the clip in time. It will be shorter if you increase the playing speed. The shorter length is indicating your line as well. In particular, the clip will end where you will notice a step. An easier way to trim the clip is to use the rate stretch tool. Hover a clip at its beginning or end. If you stretch using this tool, you won't cut any of its parts. Indeed, you will change the speed rate. So, if you shorten the clip, you will play it faster through a percentage indicated next to the clip name above. In audio clips, you have other default effects, for example to set the volume or the panning, which is the balance between the two stereo channels. The rate stretch tool works for audio clips as well. You can add further effects to your clips. On the left, you have the effects window by default. If you don't find it, go to Window and click on Effects. This window has inside the list of all effects Premiere has: audio and video effects, transitions and presets. Video and audio effects can be added to your clip simply selecting them and dragging them on it. Then you can edit this extra effect as you did with default effects. Select it from the list and then use the envelope line on your clip. As long as your envelope line is straight, the effect doesn't change in time, since the effect keeps its same value anytime. To edit effects in time, you need to use the keyframes. Keyframes, indicated through rhombuses on your envelope line, are instances of time where the value of an effect is fixed. So that, if you have two keyframes, one following another, but with different values fixed, the effect changes its properties in between of them. The envelope line itself helps you understanding it, showing you a ramp between the two rhombuses. Let's suppose to increase opacity in time at the beginning of a video clip. Firstly, we have to fix where to start changing value. So, add your first keyframe. Simply hold the Ctrl down and click on your envelope line to add one. Then fix the second keyframe to set the final value of the effect, always holding Ctrl down and fixing the value, dragging up or down the keyframe itself. Between the two, the envelope line will change, and so the effect value. Keyframes can be fully edited, moved up, down, and in time. Right-click on one and go to Delete if you want to delete it. The transition between two values can be different and fully personalized. If you right-click on a keyframe, you can choose to set the line linear, bezier, and so on. If you choose bezier, you can set curves to your envelope line, so that the effect won't change in time linearly, but with a non-constant speed. Otherwise, you can use the pen tool that you find on the left. With this, you can build even a complex envelope line between two keyframes. Click on the line to add new keyframes. You can edit the position of the keyframes, dragging them. But if you do so, holding Ctrl down, you add curves. You can adjust them through the blue handles, always holding Ctrl down meanwhile. Experience will help you at doing this in the correct way. All scene is okay for audio effects as well, of course. If you find the timeline a hard workspace to edit and set more professionally your effects, you can use another window called Effect Controls. Select a clip, for example a video. The Effect Controls window lists all the effects this clip has, in both visible and sound parts. Next to the effect names, you can use the white arrow to see all its properties, and the effects icon to enable or disable it. Use the reset button to come back to the original settings. You can change values dragging on the orange numbers, or you can click once on them to type in. If you want to use effects then change in time, click on the stopwatch icon to enable the keyframes. Here you won't see any envelope line, but the concept is the same. Just set the keyframes in time and the value in each of them. In this case, keyframes are added where you change the value in a new instant of time. There are then the presets. Presets are simply collections of effects ready to be used. Try them. Let's see the transitions. These can be video or audio ones as well, and are used to add an effect to pass from a clip to the following one. If you have a single clip, you can add a transition, selecting it and dragging it at the beginning or in the end of such clip. An icon similar to a flag will indicate you that you are going to add a single side transition that affects just a single clip. To apply a double side transition that affects two different clips, just drag the transition in between of them. To delete a transition, simply right-click and go to Clear. Be sure not to overlap the two clips, or one will be cut in length to give space to the other. A transition is shown as a dark yellow area with its name on it. You can change the kind of transition, dragging there another one from the effects window. To change its duration, so its length, simply drag its edges. The double side transitions may show strips inside. This happens when Premiere adds to stretch a video over its maximum duration to apply the transition. Try to avoid this, since the video will be stopped during some parts of the transition. Simply shorten the left clip a little and add the transition again. This should come up without any strip inside. As seen before, you can use the effect controls window to manage transitions as well. You simply need to select the right transition and its properties will show up. So you can move the transition earlier or later. Just pay attention to use a filled area or videos will be stopped for a while. You can shorten or elongate it and change properties on the left. Thanks for watching this video. Check our show to get more into Premiere Pro CC.